boys and girls, how are you? Thank you for just spending this time as we just connect, talking about God's word. Let's pray. Father, I thank you in Jesus' name. I thank you for every boy and girl here listening. Lord, I pray that you bless our time. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. So, boys and girls, I hope you had a wonderful week. Thank you for being here as we continue to talk God's word. If you have your Bible, I want you to go to Matthew 22 from verse 34 to 40. Matthew 22 from verse 34 to 40. Now, this is what God's word says there. Hearing that Jesus had silenced the Sadducees, the Pharisees got together. One of them, an expert in the law, tested him with this question: Teacher, which is the greatest commandment in the law? Jesus replied, Love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, with all your mind. This is the first and the greatest commandment. And the second is like it: love your neighbor as yourself. All the law and the prophets hang on these two commandments. Let's go to Matthew 26, from verse 6 to 13. While Jesus was in Bethany, in the home of Simon the leper, a woman came to him with an alabaster, that's something containing very expensive perfume, which she poured on his head as he was reclining at the table. When the disciples saw this, they were indignant. They were very angry. Why this waste? They asked. This perfume could have been sold at a high price and the money given to the poor. Aware of this, Jesus said to them, Why are you bothering this woman? She has done a beautiful thing to me. The poor you always have with you, but you will not always have me. That's in person. When she poured this perfume on my body, she did it to prepare me for burial. Truly I tell you, whenever this gospel is preached throughout the world, what she has done will also be told in memory of her. Now, there's another scripture I just want. It's a short one. Mark 12:30. This is what it says. Love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, and all your mind, and all your strength. Okay. Now, boys and girls, if I go like this, I'm sorry. Will you forgive me?
Thank you. I love you.
What's wrong with that? Can you see that my emotions, my behavior don't match what I'm saying? I love you and I love you. It's something different. So, these people who are called Pharisees and Sadducees. The Pharisees, they were these conservatives, the legalists at the time, and the Sadducees were a little liberal, but both of them had issues with Jesus. So the Pharisees were trying to trap Jesus, and then these Sadducees were asking him difficult questions. But what surprised both groups is the way Jesus answered the questions and behaved with a lot of wisdom. Now, boys and girls, Jesus, when he's answering these Sadducees, he says, love the Lord your God. This is with everything, with your heart, your mind, your soul, and your strength. I'll try and tell you what each of them means. But what is painful is that, maybe I should not say painful, but particularly with these guys, is that like the Pharisees, they knew the law. They knew what would call God's word today, but they didn't live it. There was no relationship. It was just head knowledge. They knew scripture, but they did not live the scripture. They knew God's word, but they didn't love the God behind the word. They didn't seem to have a relationship with God behind the word. You know, when he says, love the Lord your God, that's God, and love your neighbor, that's people. So, boys and girls, for us as Christians, if you say Jesus is your friend, we love God and we love people, okay? So, somewhere in the Bible says, how can you love God when the people around you don't love them? So, if you look at the Ten Commandments, the first four, there's only one God. That's number one. Number two, worship no other God. Number three, you must not misuse the name of the Lord your God. Number four, remember the Sabbath. Do you notice that those first four are about loving God? I love God. The next, from 5 to 10, honor your father and mother. It's people. Now it's those we relate with. So whoever is taking care of you. Number two, do not kill. Number six, do not kill. Number seven, don't commit adultery. Don't, boys and girls, tell me, don't take another man or woman's wife. Number eight, do not steal. Number nine, do not lie. Number 10, do not be jealous. Do you see that all those from number 5 to number 10 are to do with people? If you love people, you're not going to be jealous. You're not going to steal from them. Okay, you're not going to commit adultery. You are not going to kill. So, the first four, loving God. The next, loving people. Boys and girls, he says, the law and whatever, everything is summed up in what he just said. That love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your strength, with all your might. Now, thoughts, words, action, they can be put into what we are going to call the love test. Now, if you love God, you are going to love him with everything that you have, boys and girls. So, with my heart, when I say loving God with my heart, so it's the desires, it's wanting to spend time with God, wanting to hide God's word in my heart. That's, I love God with my heart. You know, with my soul, you are watching TV and mom or dad says, it's time to pray. So that means the emotions, the feelings. No, mom, I'm enjoying this. I know prayer can wait. No, 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 no. If we are, that time comes when we can go to church. So loving God with your soul is, I want to go to church. So I love this word. The psalmist says it's like honey in Psalm 119. So you are passionate about God's word. That's loving God with your soul. With your mind, boys and girls, that's your intellect. The Pharisees, it was just intellect. They knew God's word. So it's not enough. But we should also love God with our intellect, with our thought processes. Think on these things. Dwell on the word of God. Love him. Okay? Spend your mind not thinking to do evil. Your thoughts must not be about committing evil, about wanting to do good. So, the thoughts, boys and girls, if we love God, there are certain things we should not look at on the internet, on our mobile phones, on our computers. There are things we should not look at because they mess up our thoughts. You don't want to look at that. So if you love God, there are certain things I don't want, you remember we talk about garbage in, garbage out. You don't want to feed your mind with the wrong things. You want to feed your mind with things that please God. Because I love God, there are certain things I'm not going to look at. So with your strength, that's your physical, okay? I'm going to go and help the old people. I'll go at an old people's home. I'm going to go and help boys and girls who have no moms or dads. So you want to use your strength. You want to, if it means I'm going to be just volunteering to do something, that's a young person who loves God with their strength. Do you see that, boys and girls? So love God, love people, okay? Do you love God? Do you love people? So if you do that, that's what we are calling a Christian. That's what Jesus is saying to us in his word. Love the Lord your God with all your heart. But see, if you look at, there were two stories that were put here. Now, there's this woman who poured perfume. If it was today, and you can ask mom or dad, what's the most expensive perfume? This lady, because Jesus was right there. They were having dinner. He was reclined. So she pours this expensive perfume on Jesus. Expensive. Ask your mom or dad, what is the most expensive perfume today? That perfume, this lady poured it on Jesus. She showed that she loved Jesus, okay? Today, you can buy that expensive perfume, but you can't pour it on Jesus because he's not here in person. At that time, this woman could do that because Jesus was there in person. And she showed how much she loved him by sacrificing. I don't know how long it had taken her to put that money together to buy that perfume. But she showed that she loved Jesus by sacrificing that perfume there. Boys and girls, the Bible says in John 3 verse 16, for God so loved the world. God loved us so much that he sent his only son Jesus. Today, he's just saying, love God, love people. Uncle, how do I love people? I just told you those commandments. You're not going to be jealous. You're not going to steal from them. You're not going to abuse other people, not treat other children well. You're going to love them. You're going to care for them. You're going to put them first. You're going to think about them. You know, the disciples said to this lady who poured perfume on Jesus, this money could have been put together, we could have sold the perfume and taken care of the poor. Jesus said, the poor you always have. Do you know that, boys and girls, today there are people who are poor. There are children who can't have food, okay? There are children who sleep on the streets. If you love God and you love people, you are going to sacrifice. Mom, my pocket money for this week, can you put it together for me? I want it to go and help some child in some rural area to go to school. I would like this money to go and buy uniform for this boy or girl at a children's home. That shows that we are loving people. They are here. There are many poor people, boys and girls, and we are supposed to show that we love them because we love our God. So what precious things do you have, boys and girls, which maybe God is saying, sacrifice this so that we can help the poor, so that you can show that you love me by helping the hungry. You know, it's not by works. Ephesians chapter 2. It's by grace that we've been saved through faith. It's not by all the good works we can do because then we start boasting. No, it's by grace that we've been saved. So boys and girls, it is just telling us it's good to look after the poor, to do all these things. But it's important to realize it's not enough. It's not enough. We must love God to be able to love people. Those two are important. Let's put them together. Our faith must not just be talk, like the Pharisees and the Sadducees. No. There's works, but there's the grace of God. When Jesus died on the cross, he loved you and me. And is it difficult, boys and girls, that we can do the same? We can never get to do what he did, but we can love people and love God. So I want to say to you today, love God with all your heart, with all your strength, with all your might, with everything. Love Jesus. Love him. And he also says, love your neighbor. Love the people around you. Do something that you love them. Not just talk. It's not good enough. Is that okay? Father, I thank you for every boy and girl. Just listen to me. Lord, help us to love you. All our hearts, all our minds, all our soul, and all our strength. I pray that, Lord, give us the grace, the desire to love those around us. Our friends at school, those who don't even care for us, our teachers, our neighbors. Lord, help us to love them. Help us, Lord, to be able to visit the poor, the hungry, the orphans, old people, to show that, Lord, we love them and we love you. So may your name be honored. In the name of Jesus, I pray. Amen. Thank you, boys and girls. May God bless you. Have a super week.